Greetings, New Zealand naturopath Eric Bakker, author of Candida Crusher and formulator of the CanXida range of dietary supplements. Thanks for checking out this video series on Blastocystis Hominis today. Before you watch the video, please click on the screen and download my free report. It's going to help you out if you've got any kind of a gut problem. Right, so let's go into the signs and symptoms of Blastocystis Hominis infection. So when you've got a parasite infection that affects the intestinal tract, the typical symptoms that you're going to have will be, you won't have all of these. You may have one or, multiple. Abdominal pain is a big one. Now, I'm just going to stand up and show you a typical place where abdo pain is. So around the umbilical cord here, so many people could experience sensations around here or off to the sides here. But central is quite common for any kind of a gut parasite. So abdo pain is quite a common one. I've just made some notes here. So diarrhea, especially increased stool urgency. You may have gone, if you're in the States, you could have gone to holidays in the Caribbean or to Hawaii, or I'm not sure what Hawaii's like, I've never been there. But here in New Zealand, if we go to the Pacific region, if we go to countries like Samoa or Tonga or Fiji, I've had countless patients who've come back with blasto infection, where they've picked it up from water or food. So if you're in the States or if in Europe, if you've gone to a country, maybe Portugal or Spain, or a country where, again, I'm not saying anything out of turn here, but a country where the sanitation or hygiene standards may not be as good, you could have well picked up this bug. So think carefully. Have you got abdominal pain or diarrhea or nausea or constipation or just not feeling right in the gut since you've come back on holiday? This could be a red flag. This could well mean that you've got a Blastocystis infection. Gas or flatulence, especially if you've got pain. Greasy stools that tend to float. Again, look for an oil slick on the water after you've had a bowel motion. This could be a sign of blasto infection. Upset stomach or nausea or queasiness. Even the smell of food could make you a bit sick sometimes. Lots of burping or bloating. So gas, farting or flatulence or burping accompanied with abdo pain is another one that I see a lot in people. You may not have any abdo pain at all. You may just have a lot of diarrhea. So diarrhea is a common one with blasto, and we're talking anywhere from 2 or 3 bowel motions up to 10 a day. I've had many patients who could not even go and do their occupation because they had 10, 15 bowel motions per day. So if you've got lots of urgency and frequency, it could well be a Blastocystis infection. So think carefully, particularly in relation to travel or some change, what you've done. It may be summertime. You may have gone swimming in a lake or a river. You may have visited a friend on a remote property and drunk some water from a well. You may have played with pets or have domesticated or farm animals. There will always be reasons why you pick this up. Think carefully of those scenarios in relation to the symptoms. There's always cause and effect. Once you've got blasto, you may be asymptomatic, which means no symptoms for a long period of time, then develop symptoms, or you may get this bug and develop symptoms right away. So it'll be either one of the two. So I hope that gives you a bit of an insight into signs and symptoms of Blastocystis hominis infection. Stay tuned, we've got more to come. Thanks for catching up with me.